Welcome to Enots Engineering, I'm Alan. In today's video I'm looking at storing milling cutters and other cutters in the drawer that's underneath the base of your milling machine. Now the problem I have, whenever I want to choose a cutter, I have mine still in the original boxes, so it's one cutter in each box. And sometimes the boxes are not labelled, you have to go through different boxes to try and find the correct cutter. So I'm making a simple storage device that will fit in the drawer under your machine. So all your milling cutter, centre drills, end mills, counter bores, anything like that, are all stored in one place, easy to get to. So let's go into the workshop and see how we do it. Today we're looking at tool storage in the milling machine base drawer. Now if, like me, you keep your milling machine cutters, end mills, still in the original containers, when you want to find a certain size, you have to go through all the tools to try and find it. So what I want to do today is try and tidy this drawer out, get something better to hold my milling cutters in, and make this more accessible. Now if I open the drawer, you can see that here there's a gap between the top of the drawer and the top of the drawer side. So that gap I can use. And what I want to do is make some sort of tool holder to hold the tools that I have in the drawer so I can get at them easy. And also see the parts that are in the bottom of the drawer. So when I push the drawer back in, they'll fit inside without fouling the drawer. So the first thing I want to do is to check the width of the drawer. And this one is 225 millimetres, 225. And I've noticed the space above the drawer. So I could put something over here. What I'm thinking of doing is making a piece of wood that fits over the top, holds the cutters, so when I push the drawer back in, they will go inside. So first job is to get a piece of wood that's just a little bit wider than the drawer. So I think this piece of wood will be suitable, and the first thing I want to do is just square up the end of the wood. I'll make this 300 millimetres. The finished length will be about 245. But I'll just cut it a little bit bigger to give me a bit to play with in case I make a mistake. Put a mark on the wood. And cut that piece off. So I've cut this wider than the drawer sides, about 10 millimetres wider. And now I want to put a notch on each end. Now I've marked a line where I want to make the cut, but I don't want to go all the way through. I want to go about halfway. So I'll raise the blade and just check. Now I'll make a series of cuts to take the wood out down to that line, which is about 5 millimetres in. Now that forms part of the lip that holds on the top of the drawer. So this will go into the drawer. The drawer edge will come here, and that hole on the top. And we need to do exactly the same on the other end. I've already cut this 5mm wider than the drawer and marked up the cut position. Before I do any more, I'll just check that that fits. So now we have a piece of wood that just slides on top of the drawer. And that should go. The drawer still shuts, so it goes inside. I've roughly marked the centre line of the piece of wood, placed it in the vise. Now I'm going to drill a 6mm hole about an inch deep or 25mm deep. Now I'll open that up. This milling cutter is what I want to put in there. This is a 12mm cutter, so I'll open it up to till I get to 12mm, but I don't want it to be a tight fit. I want to be able to pull this out, and if it's tight I'll risk cutting my fingers when I'm pulling it out, so it needs to be a slide fit or even looser than that. This is a 10mm drill. And this drill is 12.5mm. Could have been a bit smaller, 12.5mm. Drill about 0.5mm over the sizes. But I can take that out. It's not gripping. Last thing I want to do is that to be that tight that as I take it out, my fingers run along the edge of this, cutting edge of this, and I cut my fingers. So I can grab it there, take that out. It's no problem. So now I'll move it along to the next hole and repeat that for the next size cutter. So my next cutters are 10mm, so I'll drill the 6mm hole 25mm deep again.
Set the depth.
Now open that up. Change the drill for the next one. So that's 10mm. You can see it fits, but it's tight. Let's try that. That's okay. Now what I did, I hadn't got a 10.5mm drill, and I thought 0.5mm would be a bit too big. So all I did was put the end mill in and moved the table backwards and forwards, slight amount, until it gives you a nice fit. So go on to the next one. Start with my 6mm drill again. This time, because the cutters are getting shorter, I don't need to go 25 deep. So on this one, I'll go 20 deep. should be tight. Now I'm going to use the cutter to machine out the hole. Move along to the next one.
Now here's something to watch out for. My 5mm end mill has a 6mm body.
Do another 6mm there for that. I just checked that the body and the diameter of the cutter, if they're not the same, you'll have to adjust your drills to suit.
Set my digital readout to zero.
Okay, I've carried on and I've drilled the holes. Watch it on the smaller end mills because the body is usually bigger than actually end mill itself. So if you drill, if this one's, I think it's a 3mm end mill, if you drill it 3mm, you'll still have to open it up to 4mm.
And that's what they look like when it's finished.
All I need to do next is number the size of each one on the side, and you can do that just using a felt tip pen with a fine point. So we'll see how it works. So this is the finished item. I've still got some space on the end there to add some more.
So I have my end mills on the left and counter bores on the right, and I just need to number the parts.
That fits in there, and I can push it to the back out the way if I need to get something at the bottom of the drawer, or I can leave it at the front. Now if you find that some of your milling cutters are longer and they tilt the wood like this, then what you can do is fix a small button magnet there, and that will clip it to the front of the drawer so it won't move unless you pull it away. I've made another one. On the second one I've got my spot drills, room for some centre drills or countersinks, and that can fit on the same rail. So these that I don't use a lot I can push to the back, leave these at the front.
And the drawer should close as normal.
And that's the finished item.
That's holding end mills and counter bores for cap head screws. Oh well, that's it for today. Hope that was useful. Hope it was interesting, and we'll see you next time on Enots Engineering.